Welcome back to H3 Weapon Deep Dive. We got another update 102 gun for you today. This is half of an Uzi, a quarter of an Uzi. This is the Uzi Nano. It is a special Uzi in that it is barely an Uzi. It is not even chambered in 9x19. It is chambered in 25 ACP. We are here in home pistol, machine pistol. Uzi Nano has a special magazine that gets real skinny at the top so it'll fit in there. Oh boy. What monstrosity is this? Let's find out. Let's check it out. The Uzi Nano. Let's take a look at these controls. Well, we've got our magazine well in about the only place you could possibly put it. Down on the trackpad will eject the magazine. So it has got a magazine eject, so that's nice. Your bolt handle is on the top like all your Uzis. In fact, it pulls the front sight with it. Which is lovely. It is an open bolt gun. There's your open bolt position there. You've got left on the trackpad for your safety, your selector switch. S is for safe, R is for semi-automatic, and A is for automatic. Oh, buddy, that's a lot of rounds really fast. It is a 36-round magazine. Oh, that thing goes fast. What else do we have? Does not lock open on empty. There's no bolt catch or release. You just got to rack the bolt manually each time. You want to reload it. And if you're firing on full auto, that is going to be frequently. See what attachments will fit on this guy. Rails? No, we do not have rails on here. So no lasers, no red dots. How about, muzzle brake. We've got barrel attachments. So suppressor? Yeah, I should go get the Uzi suppressor for that one. Let's use a barrel extension. Hilarious. What else we got? Oh, can we put rails on it with the adapter? We can. So you can get rails on this thing if you try hard enough. Foregrip? No foregrip. Ooh, how about a stock? No. Yes! So you can get a stock. I'm going to get one that goes straight across so it's a little easier to use with the sights. But yep, you can put a stock on it. And of course, battle spatula. Okay, I approve. Let's look at our iron sights. Well, they are, I think, Uzi iron sights. They are just really, really close together. You will be looking through the top of the bolt handle. There's a cutaway for it. You've got a rear aperture and a front tiny little spike. And they are not adjustable. I want to see if it reciprocates. No, it does not reciprocate. So that's not so bad. Let's actually try it on semi here. Ooh, that's firing awfully low. There we go. Yeah. Looks like I gotta aim about three-quarter height. Put that front, the tip of the front post at about three-quarter height. Oof, that's kind of all over the place, isn't it? Maybe it's just inaccurate. All right, let's do our recoil test. This should be interesting. 36 rounds of 25 ACP. In the interest of science and not taking forever, I put a laser on there so I can get a perfect shot in the beginning, which is what I do every time. Here we go. Okay, well, a 10 and a 1 and a 3. I think that 1 and, well, actually that 1 and 3 might be legit. Maybe the rate of fire is so fast that it actually got on the paper before it hit the ceiling, but this clearly is a ceiling shooter in its normal configuration. Let's throw a muzzle brake on there. No, we are still in the ceiling. I think those are hitting the ceiling and coming back down. I don't know, maybe they're not. Maybe they're actually getting on that paper. I don't know, those look like they're coming back down. All right, suppressor. This is a normal looking gun, sure. See, that one got on there for sure. I saw that one. Everything else is in the ceiling though. Let's try it with our stocks. Yeah, I got a straight back stock, so it's easier to see the sights, even though I'm using a laser. Ooh, significant. Guy got four on the paper that time. Oof. Oh. All right, now the real question. Will stock and muzzle brake tame this guy? A little? Well, we got 10, no, 9 of them, on, well, 10, 11 of them on the paper, but 9 of them scoring. No. Let's try stock and suppressor. Ooh, cool sound too. Got 3 of them on the paper that time. Still not good, but better than without it. Okay, in the interest of science, I put a foregrip on it. Let's see how this does. Oh, foregrip. Look at that. 36 on the paper. Most of them in the one ring, but they got on there. Okay, I realized I had the stock on there with the foregrip, so let's just try the foregrip by itself. Oh, this is hard to aim. Oh, buddy. It's not very good, but about as good as with a muzzle brake, so it definitely helps. So many combinations. Let's try the foregrip and the muzzle brake. Nah, those are all coming back down. So I think we got about 3 on the paper and the rest were hitting ceiling and coming back down. All right, we have given it every advantage. We've given it a stock, a laser, a muzzle brake, and a foregrip. Come on, little guy, let's see what you can do. Oh, 4.97, call it 5. Look at that, all on the paper. Really, really fast. Oof, oof. With enough crap on here, it's actually usable. Well, there you have it. The Uzi Nano, as little Uzi as you can get and still call it an Uzi. Oh, man. It's even got a big little speed hole in there for crosswind. I don't know what that is. Till next time, I will see ya. Seven, eight, six. Yep. Get enough crap on there, and it'll go. Bye-bye.